Anyway, there's been a lot of media coverage leading up to tomorrow's Remembrance Day events, and rightly so, for to commemorate those who fell in the two great wars. Unfortunately, still today, the government and the media have largely ignored the international brigades in the Spanish Civil War, which is a crime. They have ignored the people who were the first to stand against fascists when they tried to steal the government of Spain from its people. Why is that? Are they afraid that by not recognising it, if they recognise it, they will expose that in 1936 to 39, the so-called democratic governments of the US and of Europe tacitly supported the fascists in Spain? Are they afraid that the people may ask questions? Why did they leave fascism in Spain after they belatedly crushed the rest of fascism in Europe in 1945? To put today in its context, in the 1930s, the governments of the great Western powers sat back and allowed fascism to sweep across Europe like a cancer. On the 18th of July 1936, Spanish military officers launched a coup against the democratically elected leftist centre government of the Second Spanish Republic. The generals were backed by the aristocracy, the wealthy landowners, industrialists, financiers, and the church. They all opposed the modest social reforms, which were the programme of the popular government. The Spanish people armed themselves to defend their government, and the Spanish Civil War began. When Nazi Germany and fascist Italy provided assistance to Franco's forces, the real character of the coup was exposed. Many correctly saw Franco's coup as part of the international spread of fascism and feared that if Madrid fell, Paris and London would be next. However, the governments of Britain, France and the United States operating a policy of appeasement of fascism declared neutrality. Support groups for the Spanish people sprang up across the world to raise money, food, medical supplies and arms. Thousands went to Spain to fight with the International Brigade or to serve as doctors and nurses for the Republic. Approximately 320 from the island of Ireland went to fight with the people of Spain against fascism. 82 made the ultimate sacrifice and fell in Spanish soil. Coming from both sections of the community here, these international brigadistas recognised the perils of the growth of fascism and selflessly risked their lives trying to halt it. Their stance was correct. 5 months after the Spanish Civil War ended, Hitler invaded Poland and World War II started. In her tribute to the departing international brigades in 1938, the personification of the Spanish people's resistance, La Pasionaria, describes, "For the first time in the history of the people's struggles, there was a spectacle, breathtaking in its grandeur, of the formation of the international brigades to help save a threatened country's freedom and independence, the freedom and independence of our Spanish land. Communists, socialists, anarchists, republicans, men of different colours, different ideology, antagonistic religions, yet all profoundly loving liberty and justice, they came and offered themselves to us unconditionally. They gave us everything, their youth or their maturity, their science or their experience, their blood and their lives, their hopes and their aspirations, and they asked us for nothing. But yes, it must be said, they did want a post in battle. They aspired to the honour of dying for us. We are indeed privileged today, privileged and honoured, to have two of these men with us today. Unfortunately, Mick O'Riordan, who inspired us at the first meeting of the Commemoration Committee, passed away and never saw the sculpture. As I said last year, Mick would have been proud to know that there was no corporate sponsorship of this sculpture. There was no public-private finance initiative around this sculpture. The people who raised the money for this were like the brigadistas themselves. They were working people, trade unionists, artists, musicians and playwrights. They gave selflessly, not just to commemorate the spirit and heroism of the men of the International Brigade. They did so to bring this part of our history to people's attention. They want people to think, to motivate them to ask questions. Who were these international brigadistas? Why did they decide to fight fascism in a foreign land? Why did their governments of the day try to stop them and effectively supported the fascists? And to ask who else supported the fascists and why? The Commemoration Committee want people to learn from their history, to look at the world around them and remember the dangers of allowing intolerance and injustice to go unchallenged. We want people to act like the brigadistas, to break down barriers of hatred, sectarianism and racism. We want people to recognise their common history and to unite in their common interests. But we also want people to be vigilant. The circumstances and the forces of greed and exploitation that conjured up the fascist ideals are still with us today. Neo-fascist parties are in power in a number of countries in Europe, or they wait to seek power. The policies of Berlusconi's government in Italy against the Romani ethnic minority look suspiciously like Hitler's policies, early policies against the German Jews. We must not remain silent spectators. We must actively oppose and stamp out fascism when it first appears. This week has seen the historic election of a black person as the President of the United States of America. Important as this event is, let us not be fooled that US capitalism is becoming more human. Channel 4 aired a short programme after the evening news on Wednesday, showing the reaction of poor black Americans to the election. One community worker pointed to the slums in which he and his neighbours live and commented on the debate around McCain and Obama. And he said, when are they going to talk about this poverty in which we are living? That's what I want to hear. America is a corporation. All we have done is change the chief executive officer. And let us not forget that some of the corporations still with us today supported the fascists in the 1930s and 40s. And what is to stop them and their ilk from doing so again? To protect their interests and their profits when times get hard. Friends and comrades, we are here today to celebrate the memory of the International Brigades, men who were not motivated by money or greed. They were motivated by their faith in humanity and a love of freedom and democracy. They were men who knew a better world was possible. We are proud to be in the presence of these International Brigaders, and we'd just like both Bob and Jack to say a few words now. Thanks very much.